So the last one would be that each nakshatra, just like we talked about the beach mantra, there is another mantra also. And this is the thing, before we talk about this mantra, just like you were saying when you were telling me the story for that sheep in Assam, that how mantras are so powerful. And I still remember back in the days when rishis, sages, they used to do time travel. They used to do, they used to invoke certain things, or they used to invoke certain weapons just by using the mantras in their life or at their time. So mantra has the most say in order to achieve any remedy you want to do. So each nakshatra, yes.
Yeah, and in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there is this story of Dhruva Maharaj.
Yes, yeah.
Goes and tells, you know, oh, my mother, my stepmother insulted me, and my father didn't speak a word against her, you know. So yes. I want a kingdom greater than my great-grandfather. So right. Dhruva's father is Uttanapad. Uttanapad's father is Swayambhumanu, and Swayambhumanu's father is directly Brahma. So Brahmaji is his great-grandfather. So he wants a kingdom. And then Narad Muni, finally he tells him, you know, you worship Lord Vishnu. In that, he says, chant this mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. But something very interesting, he says. He doesn't say that, chant this, and he doesn't leave him like that. He right. says, if you do this, in the next 40 days, you will see the denizens of the higher planetary systems. So that's the first indication, you see. So I don't remember exactly, is it 40 or 60? It's one of these, 40 days. Mostly it's 40, maybe it could be 60 also. But the point here is, if you do the mantras very properly, now I'm not saying anybody who is doing mantras will see, you know, the heavens or anything. I am not saying that, but I'm saying that is an indication. There are indications of mantras working, and you know what happens. Like I have that personal experience that when I recommend mantras to my clients, and you know they do, then within 3 months or 6 months, most of them, they always send me a mail that I have stopped eating non-veg, I have stopped drinking, I have stopped watching unnecessary stuff in the internet. So it will always happen that there will be some tangible changes in your life. Although we cannot put it down that it will happen in 10 days or 5 days. It can happen in a moment. It can take 6 months, 10 years for you, depending on your sincerity.
Sincerity. Right? And that that is the same thing which I would like to add. If I know a lot of people I also get into, and they always say that why it is not working. And I always tell them, what was your intention? What was your devotion? What was your sincerity when you were doing that mantra? How serious were you? So intention has a very big role when you're doing certain mantras. And if you do it, if you give your 100% to any mantra you're doing, definitely you will get the results. Definitely.
Yes. And while doing these mantras, also it's a general caution, I would say. It's very important that we are not walking and doing it, or we are not running and doing. There are people I know who are running in the treadmill and they are chanting mantras like that.
Yeah,
this is some extreme thing I've seen. Because see, when when you are chanting a mantra, what you are doing actually, you, it's like my guru used to say, suppose I say Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, right? So it is as if I have invited Lord Vasudev, who is Krishna, to my home. All right, you are invoking his presence, right? That's absolutely what mantra is. Manatrai, that's what mantra is. Nothing more than that.
absolutely.
And now imagine, I call you to my home, okay? And then when I open the door and I'm like wearing my shoes and you know I'm going for jogging, that's ridiculous. I mean, how will you feel? Yeah. Oh, this is the importance which I have in his life. He's not even ready to talk to me. He's going out for jogging. And he says, come, jog with me also. Now, how will you feel? I mean,
yes. Beautiful point.
Yes. When you are chanting mantras, if you are sitting in the ground, you should not just sit. You should have an asana, right?
Yeah.
That could be a kusha grass, or that could be a chatai, or that could be any carpet. Or carpet means not the ones where they put the feet, but it could be anything. You know, it could be a fresh towel also, because when you are chanting the mantra, you are invoking, and especially when you are doing Rishi mantras, it is very, 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 very important. Like there's a mantra for Vyasdev.
Okay.
Doing that, then it is highly essential that we sit properly in asana and we do it. And after taking bath, this should be done, and it should not be done just like that. All right. So.
Right. Yeah, no, beautiful point. That's why I have not mentioned here the full mantra, because yeah. I know people have the habit of, as soon as they're going to see the Magga and they see they're having a focal planet in Magga, they might start doing it. You always, always, always need to consult your guru, your teacher, your astrologer for certain mantras. You don't want to invoke them just like that, just like you have beautifully mentioned. So great point. Great point. Babaji. So yeah, so these were the 11 short precise techniques in order to activate certain nakshatras, and there
11 missiles.
So I'm not saying that these are the only techniques. There might be 11 more, 22 more, 32 more, but these were the ones I can think of instantly for the on a basic level, so that everybody can relate to nakshatras and can start doing it and start observing it. And there's another thing coming to my mind.
Just put the screen, you know. Stop the screen share, maybe. Yeah.
So there is another thing which is coming to my mind, like the another technique other than this 11th techniques or the activations we have spoken of. For Bharani, one of the asanas in yoga is Shavasana. So spending 2-3 minutes in Shavasana, as we know, Bharani is related to death. And what happens when you go and doing the Shavasana in yoga, you are basically doing the Shav, like you are no more.
Shav means dead body.
Dead body. So basically what you're doing is you're activating Bharani at that moment. Or if you have certain planets in Bharani, then this is one of the most important yoga exercise. You must be doing it. Because Shavasana, what I know of my knowledge is, as I'm not a yoga expert, is absolutely calming your state of mind with pin drop silence, with no movement at all, no movement, and you are basically calm. So that's one of the another technique you can use it for Bharani.
Yeah, and regarding this Shavasana only, it is highly, highly, highly recommended that when we are sleeping, we should sleep like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise, what happens is, if you do not sleep like that, if you are sleeping, you know, like the opposite, or you are putting your legs or hands like this, like that, you know, then what happens is, nowadays what is happening, the people, their postures have become very bad. You see, they don't, yeah. They are not straight, they are, you know, like this or like this, they are bent over. So what happens is, 8 hours a day, if you are breaking the system of your spinal cord, then according to yogic sutras, what happens is the entire structural imbalance is there of your bones.
Yeah.
And then there are some things, you know, for example, there are some people who cannot just sit like this. Suppose there's a chair, you know, they cannot just sit like this. They sit with the legs crossed. Have you seen?
Yes. Yeah.
Always. Yeah. If you tell them why you're sitting like this, they're like, oh, I don't know. Automatically that happens. Some people I have seen, when they will get into the trains, they'll sit with the legs crossed, or they will put one leg over the other like this. So these are indications that your body is not, the bone structure is not behaving normally.
normally.
This is because in the sleep you are sleeping in a wrong posture.
Right.
And that is one of the biggest, this is the last thing I will tell you, and maybe this is the most shocking thing I've heard till now.
Right.
If you are not in sattva guna, mode of goodness,
right,
you try to sleep straight, you will not get sleep. This is a,
oh, really?
This is a very big secret I'm telling you.
Oh, wow.
That is why I always tell people, sleep like that. Mm. Yeah? And they're like, I try to sleep, but I don't get sleep.
Right.
Why? Because the day's activities are in rajoguna and tamoguna. Mm. That is why in the night, you cannot be in sattvaguna. It's not possible. Then you have to change a posture. Then some postures are in tamoguna, some are in rajoguna.
Mm.
Okay, then the next day, the further during the day, because you slept like that, it gets reinstantiated. So it's like a cycle. So now the remedy for that is start sleeping straight. For the first some of the days, you will not get sleep.
Yeah, it will take time to practice this.
Yes, but please, for God's sake, sleep straight.
Mm.
And it is always said, the thing which you have, you know, the pillow, it should not be very big.
Right.
Because that will also, you know, it's like not very good. That destroys the balance. So these are some of the things. And
no, it's good. It's good, Baba Jiji, that you have shared these beautiful points.
One last thing I will share. Sorry to interrupt you. When I visit spiritual communities, or when I was in a spiritual community in Chennai, I don't wish to be judgmental or think bad about anybody.
Yeah.
But in my limited experience I have seen, in the places where I have stayed, some of my seniors I have seen, the most dedicated spiritual warriors, I would say. Not followers, warriors. You know, it's like in Kali Yuga, practicing core spirituality, it's like fighting a war.
Right.
Because the entire universe is surcharged with Rahu, you know. There you are following in the footsteps of Vamandev, Jupiter. It's next to impossible. And I have seen them, you know, specifically I can name two or three of them who are the most dedicated ones. They always used to sleep straight. And we used to put our alarm at 3:45 in the morning. And as soon as it is 3:45, what would happen? They would directly go up like this.
Yeah. I have all, and now, after you have mentioned this thing, I can recall the ashrams I have also visited in the past. All the rishis or priests I have seen, they sleep in the same pattern. Now I know.
There you go. You got it.
Now I know. But I could never imagine before.
And another observation I have had. Another observation regarding this only. The people who I have seen not sleeping in the right posture.
Yeah.
Or in a very bad posture, which, rather than calling it not nice, it's a very bad posture. Unfortunately, they have left practicing spirituality after some time. Now, again, as I said in the beginning, I don't wish to be judgmental like this.
Or maybe they are having some obstacles into their spiritual life. We can also say
yes, that. Yes, yes. Or they are themselves going to places and, you know, doing things which is not conducive for your soul. Right. So this is what. But again, as I said, it's like a cycle. You know, if your day activities are like this, you will not get sleep.
No, but it's good that Baba Jiji, you have spoken about this subject, because a lot of people are going through spinal issues these days.
Yes. Yes.
So this was, I think, must talk.
And the funny thing is, people say, na, they will put, many times people tell me, when I tell them that chant mantras, they say, oh, you know, it's difficult. Morning, I have to snooze my alarm always. Mm-hmm. Then I tell them that, just think. You are snoozing the alarm. You just try sleeping straight, you know. Then it's very easy to get up like this, you see. But suppose you are sleeping, you know, in some other posture, then how do you get up? You have to be straight first, right? Then you get up. So that is like saying, I am coming from rajoguna to sattvaguna in the morning, and then I am getting up, which is very difficult.
Yeah.
So instead of that, you sleep in a posture which will, you know, encourage sattvaguna. Then for you to get up is very easy.
Great point.
Because you try, na, you sleep on your stomach, and then you try to get up. It's very difficult.
Yeah.
And morning time, you're already in tamoguna, and the posture is also in tamoguna. That it's like double problem, you see.
Right.
So at least we can sleep like that, then we can get up like this. Yeah. And I have seen these two, three people who I mentioned, whenever the alarm would go up, my God, they'll get up like a missile. And when I say missile, I don't mean, they were some lean, thin fellows, 30, 40 kilos. No, they were like quite well built.
But it beautifully makes sense, Babaji, because all the themes and patterns are coming into my mind, and I can recall whatever ashrams I have visited in Delhi or other places. I used to see the priest lying down on a chatai, because they only use chatai. They don't have Tempur-Pedic mattresses. So they sleep just like that, the way you are mentioning. So now I know the logic behind it. Why? Beautiful point. So yeah, a lot of things
In fact, there are some experts who can tell you the kind of posture you sleep in, the kind of problems you will have in life.
Wow.
Like there is a posture where suppose you're sleeping like this, but one of your leg is up like this, this.
Yeah.
Okay. Like one leg is down. Yeah.
You're using your one leg.
Then I have seen in my experience, these are very shocking things which I have seen.
Wow.
These people I have seen, they always have problems with their higher authorities.
Okay.
Because see, one leg is up like this. So right. That's like an indication of the ego that, I am also somebody, I am something, I am also important, I am this, I am that, Then when your higher spiritual authority, your Guru Maharaj says something, you are like, okay, I can do it, but how about doing it like this, I have seen this. It's like right, left. And I have the last thing I will say here. Though I have seen some people sometimes, they will sleep, they will sleep opposite and their hands and legs will be out like this.
All over the place.
Most disbalanced people I have seen. I don't know where they have planets or what is there. The most disbalanced people I have seen, they are not able to balance their spiritual and material and life. And this is their constant complaint. And what they end up doing is, because you cannot, if your material and spiritual life is not balanced, your default tendency, as my guru says, will be to give more time to material life. Because suppose you are not studying when you should study, you are just wasting time. Then when your exam comes, you cannot say, I have to do mantras now, right? Then you will say, no, I have to study. Because material life is like that. Your neck will... it will not spare you after some time.
Yes.
Then your spirituality gets compromised. I have seen this.
Beautiful point. Beautiful.
Just
point.
One sleep. Nothing much. Nothing fancier. Very simple, I have seen.
So basically, Shav Asana becomes one of the most important asana then.
Yes.
Just lying down straight.
Because why? Because when you are sleeping, it is like a temporary moksha, and moksha at a physical level, you are dead. That's what savasana is. Otherwise, savasana would be some other asana, right?
Great. See, even I did not know that. Beautiful point, Babaji. Beautiful.
Always. So, it's like always.
Beautiful. So it was a beautiful video, and I know your audience like the short videos on the exotic astrology, and we have already passed close to 1 hour, but it was a beautiful
like whoever speaks they will like, and especially when handsome people like you are there.
Thank you. And
thank you very much for
such
coming.
Such a beautiful honor you have given me, and I really thank you with my humble heart. And I still cannot tell you how happy I was, and I still am, to be associated with you in every form. And what I have learned, especially about the Bhagavad Gita, before knowing you, I was not that much attracted toward Bhagavad Gita. But after I met you, even in my life, the Bhagavad Gita got more active. So for that, thanks goes to you. Thanks goes to Bharat Ramji, who introduced you into my life, because just after your video on my teacher's channel, I got to know about you. So here also we can see how we all, even your viewers, and I am also one of your viewers, we are all connected to each other. And there is a destined time for each and everything, for a bigger reason, for a main reason, or for whatever reason you can think of.
And Bhagavad,
so I think it was my time to get more inclined towards the shlokas, towards the Bhagavad Gita. And that's where your entry came. So thank you.
Thank you so much for coming, and we will do more sessions like this in the future. And once you come back, you are going somewhere. So once you come back, and I will also be going to Berlin for Rath Yatra festival. Again, you see, Punarvasu will be active 20th July, Berlin, Germany. Whoever is there, please come to the Rath Yatra festival in Brandenburger Tor. It's the most famous place in Berlin. And I will also be meeting Mananji, his brother. And I've also told him, you know, you need to book the slot. And you must be there that time.
I was there.
And on 2nd August, the Rath Yatra is in Munich. So whoever is in Munich can also join there. And I guess by that time, Punarvasu themes will
start going. So a lot of opportunities you're getting through the cosmos. If you have missed one, you will get it in a repeatedly way in the second one.
Yes, and we also have it in Cologne. All right, it's on the back-to-back dates, you know. Back-to-back dates, so that everybody can attend in the weekends. So it is always on Saturdays, because on Sundays Germany is totally closed. There's nobody here, and the weekdays everybody is in office. So Saturday is the day, you know, the day of Saturn.
Wow.
Amazing.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much. And the last thing is, you also have a channel where you don't have much videos now, but you will upload in the future. And your website, I will pin it down. Yeah. You also do consultations. So if you guys, whoever is watching this, you are inspired by him, by his amazing talks, so then you can always go down to the...
My consultations are more based on nakshatras, because my niche is that. So,
So if you exclusively want to know about nakshatras and how the nakshatras are playing and when they will play out and how to activate and, you know, do all the crazy stuff which he has been doing from last 1 hour, then he's the main man. All right. So you can go there, and thank you very much, and hope to see you very, very soon in the near future.
We will. Right. Thank you.
Thank you.